What is going on, fellow outlaws, and welcome back to Destiny Shoots. We've got a whole bunch of things to get through today, so don't change the channel. As you can see, I'm in a shootout series, so let's join the live recording. What happens when there's plenty of players on the field? Oh, who's running up on me? Routine kill with the Sawdust there. And we've got one guy down here. Let's see where he's going. Oh, nope, someone's shooting me from the other side. Let's go down this way. Damn, I'm running a long way for this kill. Whoop, whoop. And now I've got to run all the way back again. This is getting exhausting, guys. There's actually quite a lot of players in this session, but you wouldn't think it. It's almost as if everyone's hiding. Where's this guy going? Boom. I don't think he even saw me. We've got one guy the other side of this bush. I'm going to come through the bush. Whoop, whoop. All day long. Here we go. This is where the party is.
This is whack. I can't get jiggy with this shit.
Right, let's see if anyone else is respawned down this side. Whoop, whoop. If you're fighting on the front foot, make sure people don't catch you out. There's plenty of high level players, decent level players running around today getting caught with the same face shot. Remember, I do run around with my chin up, but only in situations where I know I'm not going to get caught. Of course, from time to time, I get caught just like everyone else. What's this dude doing? Let's see if he wants to square off on me. Yep, he does. Double hat shot. Okay, he's got a few objects around him, so I'm just going to back off a little bit. Obviously, the area that he's got the bush and everything else. Is this dude coming through? Okay, let's run up on this guy. I'm going to go to the right side of the object. There we go. So if I would have continued on the left side, hold on, let me just take this dude out. A few dives. I think that could have been the same guy from before. But of course he didn't have anything covering him this time. Good shot there. And that's the thing, sometimes players will run on the left hand side of the object. So of course you have to run slightly outwards from the object if you're going to do it from the left hand side. But if you do switch the camera view, remember you can't run at full pace while you're switching the camera view. There's plenty of points to be made here. Whoop, whoop. Now, if some of you dudes have noticed, again, I'm going to use the right side. He didn't stand a chance because of that. I would have seen him before, or way before he would have seen me. Again, using the right-hand side of the fence. Guys, if you look at my gameplay, I'm using it every single time. Wow, this dude's got $2 internet, clearly. He's lagging all over the place. Yeah, so remember, dudes, if you are going to switch the camera view, it's because you're in a stationary position and you're not looking just to run up on your opponent. If you do run up on your opponent from the left-hand side, 9 times out of 10, you're going to lose because they can run faster than what you can because you're switching your camera view. As you can see, guys, I've now taken the lead. I had half of the points of the current player in first position. I've managed to catch up. Okay, let's use dynamite just to get him out of the bushes. Oh, when he's used the same bush trick that I use on players coming through the bush with a shotgun, shout out to Cosworth. Now if I go over there and make the kill, I should win this one. And if we just probably just chuck another stick of dynamite in there. Whoa, this guy's holding me up. Oh, and I took it on the bell. Good game, everyone. Okay, dudes, what we're going to be doing today is I'm going to be answering a lot of questions, and also a lot of questions from critics and haters that are also sub to my channel. Unfortunately for them, it always makes good content. But for now, let's take a look at the next showdown. Okay, what is this dude doing? Yeah, it's about time we done some showdowns in the Lanik area as well. Of course, this one is Name Your Own Weapon, where the axe has most points. Double kill there with the axe, well done. I mean, in any of the Name Your Weapons, the scores can get a little bit messy at times. Yeah, that one didn't go through the wagon, unfortunately. So let's see what we've got down here. Yeah, so this one is, it's more to do with how many people can nail the most axe shots. You will get dynamite coming up shortly. That's worth a good few points, but you don't really get a lot of it. So good shot there. Again, that's a good example where sometimes I'm running around myself with my head up and you don't see someone, not like this guy. And sometimes you just can't get out of that situation, especially when someone starts shooting you from the back. They've essentially already got a head start on you. So it's inevitable. This guy didn't see me at all. I don't even think that guy even bothered looking to see if anyone was there. Something I used to do when I first started playing this game. Okay, textbook axe shot. Wow, I still died. Double axe shot. Only a couple of points behind, but quite a lot of time left on the board, so it's like that dude there, he couldn't have done anything about that. It's just unfortunate. That was a good shot by that player there. That was kind of like a running corner paint he done there, hence the reason why he dropped the weapon to his side, because I was painted more than once. So good shot by that player. I don't know what that dude was doing. He had an arrow, actually. I'm going to pick that up. The arrow is worth quite a lot of points in Lanik, so just look out for that one. Let's see how many points I can get for this. Okay, so about 9 points I got for that, which is not too bad considering, but there's not a lot of arrows around. Let's see what this dude's got. Oh, it's the same player again. Okay, this one's going to be... Let's see if I can just... take him out while he's on the ground. To be honest, I actually got him with a running corner paint as well, but the second shot hit his hat. But this one's going to be a fist fight. I've got no stamina, so yep, we're going for the shotgun. Yeah, getting involved in a fist fight halfway through a showdown is a pretty bad idea. While you're doing that, someone else is going to beat you on the board. Let's just pick my hat back up. And we're good to go. So just to answer a few questions, some dum-dum messaged the channel the other day implying that I'm using Cronus, which is a bit funny since I swoop left and right on nearly every single shot that I actually do. Cronus only pushes it up towards the head when I'm actually going left and right. So yeah, keep guessing. And if that's not good enough, check out the videos where I record my control pad and hit the exact same shots. Yeah, so we're looking pretty comfortable at the moment anyway. There are some good players in this session, but not really players that are really making their gains based upon the scoreboard. Let's see if this player is actually going to come out. Dude, did you actually just attempt to jump over that fence? Wow. Whoa, and that guy missed my head by about an inch. Let's see if he can finish me off. I don't know what he's aiming at there. But this is going to cost him. Okay, thanks for coming. I'm pretty sure I'm going to show an instant replay of that. Woo! I don't even know how that dude can miss that shot and then get killed like that. Anyway, that was a good shot there by that player with the shotgun. My animation was still just trying to drink the tonic, so I couldn't have beaten him with the shotgun. I needed to take position before I came out. However, I didn't do that, and that cost me the kill.
You motherfuckers!
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, what is this? Huh? This is whack! I can't get jiggy with this shit!
Okay, we're going to be answering some of the questions that have been sent in. And the first question, fun fact for all, King Coco has no idea he has been spotlighted in numerous kill clips here. Okay, that's a bit random. I did, however, forget the part where King Coco did
didn't have a voice and opinion of his own, but thank you for speaking on his behalf. I mean, the thing is, if you remove his dick out of your mouth for like 2 seconds, you'll understand that when you go into any shootout, everyone's entitled to record whatever they want. People can upload it to their activity feeds, their stories on Instagram. Everyone can record. So therefore, me clipping whoever I want to in a shootout is down to me, and that hasn't got anything to do with you. The problem that this dum-dum's actually got is the fact we make training videos, so it's irrelevant what players we choose to use. If I wanted to make a kill montage on Coco with like 100 kills, then I would do that, wouldn't I? And the thing that's going to make this comment look stupid, every time I go into a showdown, would I then message 20 players in that showdown and say, oh, by the way, I killed you and you're going to end up in the video? And that pretty much makes you a dum-dum. Okay, and moving on to the next message. Little thing about the Cold Clan, the leader, Nebencaster, is a 40-year-old man, maybe more. He plays with 15-year-old kids and some people that are 18+. He brainwashes kids into believing him and only him. The dude has 2 kids, a wife, and he's always online. He stays always online hacking the MSF and accusing them for hacking when he's doing it. His clan or crew, whatever, is just terrible. People should seriously antagonize this person, as he may be dangerous due to the fact that he has a wife and 2 kids, as I said before, and he plays with kids online. Yeah, I definitely don't think anyone should antagonize anybody. Let's not forget the fact that this is just a game. If somebody is trying to hack you or pursue your family's privacy or anything like that, when people start identifying who people are in real life and then going after their families, it's a big issue and it's very, very concerning. Those people need to be brought to the attention of the rest of the community. That's what we've done in this situation. Cheaters will be dealt with in a different matter altogether. The leader, Nebencaster, has been stalking people's family, so I don't really need to say any more on that situation. Their way of hitting back at me for exposing them is by saying that they won a CVC. We've beaten them in 5 CVCs, so whatever they want to make up in their own time is down to them. To be honest, even members of the team have said that this is one of the worst posses we've actually ever CVC'd against. The quality is absolutely poor. Now, I just wanted to give a shout out to every single player that follows this channel, all for the right reasons as well. All the players that have supported me since the beginning, since I've had around 50 to 100 subs, massive shout out to all of you guys. It's been an absolute pleasure to teach players how to play this game, or just to enlighten them into things they didn't know before. Of course, the channel will have its own fair share of haters, as all channels do. People will slowly start realizing that there's no all-time best player on this game. That doesn't exist. Okay, the next toxic player we want to talk about is PIB Card. This guy wanted to be on the channel a couple of months ago, but we found out that he's a toxic little shit that's been banned on several different accounts. He then started saying, oh, he's better than me and all this nonsense, which is fantastic. But the rumors going around Red Dead Online at the moment is PIB Card lost to Sensei 5-0 on the island. So sorry about that, buddy. Pick yourself up. Don't be toxic to anyone. You've got no one to blame but yourself. Now, dudes, we do like to share some of this information because, just like you guys, I'm a player first and foremost. And when we incur toxic players on a daily basis, I very much like to share that with you guys, because there is no difference. I get it just as much as everyone else. And it is important that people do stand up for themselves to a certain extent, as long as it doesn't go too far. The smartest people in this game will just say nothing and walk away. Okay, now Noob of the Week goes to Octizzy. I won 2 back-to-back showdowns over the weekend, and this player was acting salty afterwards. He wanted to be toxic because, quite frankly, I beat him. I reminded him of the position that he came in and what his kill to death ratio was. He killed 12 players and he died 13 times. He came in 7th position. Now, this is where it started to get interesting. When he asked me for a 1v1, I gave him
multiple different games that we could play against each other. For example, snipe fighting, free aim fighting, and first to two in CBCs. Now, this dude decided to duck. He then removed his comment saying that he can't free aim and he can't snipe, so all of his little friends didn't see the fact that he ducked. And then he tried to do everything just to get me in a free roam session. He tried telling me that there's no rules whatsoever. We can use anything we want. So basically what he's saying is I'll join his free roam session and we can blow each other up with dynamite arrows. So I literally said to him, okay, first to 20, we can use dynamite arrows and E-rounds, which he found hilarious. Now, you've got 0% chance of me getting involved in dumbness like this in the first place. And let me show you all the reasons why, first of all, he didn't want to snipe with me. This is him in a team event. And by the way, he got no kills on me at all in all of these events. This is him attempting to snipe from behind a rock. This is how good his shootout IQ is. As you can see, he's walking straight past the player that's aiming on him. Like, what's that about? He's running directly past somebody that's right next to him and he has no idea what's going on. And here's another example. He has absolutely no IQ in shootouts whatsoever. He's just running past players and he doesn't even know that they're there.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
Now, when someone starts shooting you in the back, you're supposed to duck. And this is what happened when he had a free shot on me from behind. Okay, and this is the most controversial thing of all. This is him stating that this game is dead. This is him stating that nobody's ever heard of me, but he's very excited to add it to his Instagram made up story. Okay, where's everyone hiding? I always do enjoy playing in tall trees. We get a lot of players actually leaving the session here because obviously everyone can actually use a dynamite arrow and you can be just blown up by a random. So some players don't like that, but it's all part of the fun and you just got to find the best way of winning. Now, the secret I normally use for this type of event is not to run too close to the center. You have to bear in mind that people are going to respawn around the outside of this particular showdown, so it's best to run around like this dude here. You can see he's literally just spawned in. Now if I run to the middle, no one's going to spawn. Now these are just the facts of the game, so I like to kind of keep it to the outside. I will go into the middle. It's just that you're more prone to being shot in the back of the head. Remember, no one shows up on the map. But to be honest, I am the type of player, I like to see what other players are going to do in the session, how they play, what sort of strategy that they're using. This player seems like he knows what he's doing. Thought I was going to have to fight in the crab position then. Yeah, there's some decent players in the session, but it's all about how you work the actual showdown. Remember, after you learn every move that's available in the game, it's down to you to decide what you actually want to use. If something's not actually working for you, then you need to change things up and just get used to what works for you. Now, as you can see, I've kind of cleaned out the spawn point
around me, and now I'm having to go more towards the centre. Because these dudes are showing up on the map, it does actually encourage me to move forwards, take them out. Let's see if I can just get the dynamite away. And is he falling for the trick? Yes, he has. So yeah, the dynamite is obviously worth the most amount of points on here. So you do actually have to strike a few dynamite kills. If you come across AFK players, they're normally lurking on the outside. You can actually just use your machete and get maximum points for those kills. A lot of people do that as well. Some people don't actually see that as fighting, or not actually trying to engage in the fighting. I do agree with that, but if I do come across an AFK, the machete is coming out. Simple as that. Let's see if I can take this guy out with the pistol. That's a good shot there by that player. That was sneak up attack. And that's the good thing really about playing with the RNG style. There's always a lot of running involved. But the thing is you're learning to fight while running at full pace. And as you can see, I come up and down all the time. I run when I have to run. I crouch back down the second I see a player. You can see every time I crouch back down again. Make myself as small as possible. A little bit of movement, and then it becomes a bit more strategic. Now, while I'm on the mic, massive shout out to Izzy Romo. An important piece of gameplay I saw there the other day. He went straight after a lag switcher. The lag switcher put himself in the same position every single time. And we're definitely looking forward to exposing this cheater. It's one of the most obvious lag switches I've ever seen, and it is fantastic work by Izzy. So shout out to Izzy Romo. If anyone does want to check out Izzy's channel, he's doing some cool things over there, so check that out. I'll leave the link in the description below, and we very much look forward to exposing the cheater. So the only downside to some of these events, and I actually find the same thing in Takeover series, is the bullets. When you pick up a weapon, the bullets are really limited. Whoop whoop. So you're constantly looking around for more ammunition. In this circumstance, obviously, I'm actually full when it comes to these pistols. Just unlucky there by that player. Very tight indeed. Yeah, so we're 20 points in front. I mean, unless someone starts blowing themselves up, can't really see this one as being a loss. I only really need to kind of protect the lead, and that's about it. Okay, this one looks like it's over. Everyone that's been watching, thank you very much. Everyone that supports me. We have loads of content coming. We've got exposing cheaters coming up. And apart from that, if you're new to the channel, please do remember to like, share and subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next video.